हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू कॉमर्स अड्डा। सो गाइस, इन यूजीसी नेट पेपर 1 यूनिट नंबर 9 वन मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इज दैट कन्वेंशन प्रोटोकॉल्स एंड एन एग्रीमेंट। ऑलवेज देयर हैव बीन अ क्वेश्चन इन द यूजीसी नेट एग्जामिनेशन, सो लेट अस ट्राई टू डिस्कस ऑल द एग्रीमेंट्स इन अ सिंगल चार्ट विद द ईयर ऑफ द एग्रीमेंट आर अ कन्वेंशन एंड द नेम फुल फॉर्म ऑफ दैट वन एंड द ऑब्जेक्ट। द इंटेंशन बिहाइंड दिस वीडियो इज टू मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड द टोटल एग्रीमेंट्स एंड इट्स पर्पस ओनली। In detail version of these agreements will be discussed in the upcoming videos. Like one important only I will be making it, like only Rio Summit, only Kyoto Protocol, only Paris Agreement, only Montreal Protocol, like that we'll try to do a separate short videos. Now let us start with the hierarchy from 1961 to 2016, how the conventions have been taken place and how it got evolved with their year and the purpose of it. So if I start with the 1961 year, that is Worldwide Fund for the Nature in the year 1961, WWF, Worldwide Fund for the Nature. The intention behind this convention is that to create a world where people and wildlife can thrive together. That means we need to protect the wildlife sanctuaries, and that is why wildlife sanctuaries are evolving because of the WWF only. You can remember in that way. When I am taking a lecture, try to open your notebook and put it in a landscape mode. Try to write the year and the convention name and the purpose of it, so that you can make one table by end of this video. Next, second one, after 10 years, Ramsar Convention took place in the 1971. This Ramsar Convention, the subject matter is that wetland is a subject matter for the conservation and conservation and sustainable utilization of the wetland. So Ramsar Convention in the year 1971, wetland is a subject matter. Next, Stockholm Declaration 1972, exactly after an year of the Ramsar Convention, 1972 is the convention which is a Stockholm Declaration. That was the most important which gave birth to many of the summits which are upcoming in nature. Look at Stockholm Declaration 1972. The intention behind this or purpose of this is that international protection of the environment. That means every matter have been covered under the Stockholm Declaration. And after that, sites. Sites in 1973. So this sites main intention is that sites full form. Let me tell you the full form of the sites over here. Sites, Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species of the Wild Flora and Fauna. So flora means a life, fauna means a animal life, and flora means a human life. That's what the convention is on. Sites 1973. You can remember in that way. And here, to control or prevent the international commercial trade in endangered species for the product derived from them. And CMS in the year 1979. Here, Convention on Migratory Species. CMS stands for Convention on Migratory Species. In the year 1979, this took place. This Convention on Conservation of Migratory Species of a Wild Animals is a main subject matter over here. So, 1961 WWF. Ramsar Convention 71 and 72 Stockholm Declaration, 73 sites, that is endangered species, flora and fauna, and CMS, Convention on Migratory Species 1979. After the CMS 1979, which is Convention on Migratory Species, let us go into the 1982, which is Nairobi Declaration, that is in the year 1982, for achieving the sustainable development, this Nairobi Declaration have been taken place. Next, most important one is that 1985, which is an Vienna Convention on the reasons of identifying or ozone depleting substances. Reasons have been identified in this Vienna Convention for the protection of the ozone layer. So, Vienna Convention, the first convention which is exclusively held for the ozone depletion is that Vienna only in the year 1985. Exactly after the 2 years, 1987, after the 2 years, Brundtland report on the sustainable development came into picture. Brundtland report is the report which have been defined. What do you mean by sustainable development? So they only defined sustainable development is nothing but the without foregoing the like future resources. We need to preserve some resources for the future generation also, without compromising on the present needs. We should have the resources for the future generation. That sustainable development definition have been given in the Brundtland report submitted in the year 1987. In the same year 1987, a Montreal Protocol has been taken place. That is, to control the ozone depleting substances. If you look at the Vienna Convention, Vienna Convention identified the ozone depleting substances. Then Montreal Protocol is saying how to control those ozone depleting substances. Here, what are the ozone depleting substances? Here, how to control those ozone depleting substances? 1985, 1987, both are interconnected to each other because both are on the ozone only. Next, another most important aspect, which is a favorite question always of the NTA, is that 1992. Once upon a one fine day, one summit held in the Rio de Janeiro place, that is Rio Declaration or a Rio Summit in the year 1992. This is an environment conservation and development report or a declaration. From this Rio Summit only, there are various things which were came out. Let me tell you what were the outcome. In the Rio Summit, first outcome is that United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, that is UNFCCC, came into picture in the 1992 because of the Rio Declaration only. That means Rio Declaration or Rio Summit or Earth Summit held in the 1992 gave a birth to three documents, that is Rio Declaration, Agenda 21 and 26 Forestry Principles have been given as a document. And Rio Declaration is also one of the document only under the Rio Summit held in 1992. Apart from those three documents, there are three conventions also have been born out of the Rio Summit. Those are UNFCCC and UNCCD, that is CCD, United Nations Convention on Combat Desertification. And after that, another also came out, that is Convention on Biological Diversity, that is CBD, also came out because of the Rio Summit only. Let us try to discuss UNFCCC. United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change held in the year 1992, which is evolved from the 1992 Rio Summit only. And here, reducing the greenhouse gases, not phasing out the greenhouse gases, reduction of the greenhouse gases as maximum as possible, so to combat against the global warming. That is the main intention or a purpose. After that, another outcome of the Rio Summit is that UNCCD, that is United Nations Convention to Combat Desertification, in the year 1992. The purpose here is to convention to combat the desertification is the main purpose. This is also one of the outcome of the Rio Summit 1992. After that, under the UNFCCC, we are having a two agreements. That is Kyoto Protocol and the Paris Agreement, which were evolved under the UNFCCC concept only. That is, Kyoto Protocol is in 1997. In the year 1997, Kyoto Protocol got established. In Kyoto Protocol in 1997, this is to fight global warming by reducing the greenhouse gases. Correct now? Subject matter of the UNFCCC and Kyoto Protocol, greenhouse gases reduction only. And Paris Agreement in the 2016, this is to limit the global warming. Same. Here to combat the global warming. Intention behind the global warming reduction is that reducing the greenhouse gases. That means UNFCCC gave a birth to Kyoto and Paris Agreement. Kyoto 1997 and Paris Agreement 2016. Next, Cartagena Protocol. That is evolved out of UNCCD. That is combat against the desertification. So it is to protect the biological diversity from the potential risk posed by living modified organism result from the modern biotechnology. This Cartagena Protocol 2000 evolved out of this combat desertification convention only. After that, Stockholm Convention again. After the Stockholm Declaration 1972, here it is there. But whereas this Stockholm Declaration, that was, now this is 2001 Stockholm Convention. That was on total protection of the environment. Here, Stockholm Convention is of protect the human health and environment from the persistent organic pollutant. This is also protecting a human health, which was held in 2001. And after the 2001, Nagoya Protocol is there, that is 2010. Nagoya Protocol, which is the 2010, this is mainly about genetic resources. Fair and equitable sharing benefit arising from the utilization of a genetic resources. So Nagoya, which is a 2010, this is one of the agreement which comes under the Convention on Biological Diversity only. Now after the 2010, Rio Plus 20 has been held. That is Rio Plus 20, which is in the 2012. Here this is also called as an conference on sustainable development. Why it is called as an Rio plus 20? Why it is called as an Rio plus 20? Because this is exactly after Rio summit, exactly after 20 years this is happening. That is why Rio plus 20 we call it as a. Then now that is Rio summit conference on sustainable development. Actually this is the conference or this is the summit Rio plus 20 which gave a birth to sustainable development goal that we are presently following, which is a 2016-30 target. After that Minamata convention in the 2013, we know Minamata convention, the essence of the Minamata, protect the human health and environment from the anthropogenic emission and release of the mercury. So the Minamata is a disease held in the Japan, Minamata disease, because of the mercury poison only. And Kigali agreement in the year 2016, guys, Kigali agreement, which is in the 2016, again this is an outcome of convention on biological diversity, Nagoya and Kigali agreement. So here Kigali agreement is to phase down the hydrofluorocarbons by reducing the manufacture and consumption. So hydrofluorocarbon reduction, not greenhouse gases, hydrofluorocarbon is one of the greenhouse gas. They are trying to reduce only that HFCs, which is Kigali agreement. This Kigali agreement is one of the main amendment to the Kyoto protocol only, right? So this is how the total all the convention at a single place, guys. Just it is up to you to make a note of it so that you can remember for a longer period of time. Pakka damn sure question you can expect. Concise manner, I tried my best to give it in one shot. So please do take a screenshot or take a like, you can make a note from the class itself. So please do learn this one and there will be a damn sure question. And do not forget to subscribe and hit the like button if you like the session, and do comment how you felt about the session so that we'll also get to know whether whatever we are doing is reaching or not, we'll get to know. And please do hit the like button and share it with your friends, and do not forget to subscribe and press the bell icon. Thank you so much. We'll be meeting in the next video. Thank you.